At this point, we're well aware that Hitmaka is an in-demand record producer, but he's also been behind the scenes at the record labels being an executive. He was recently the executive vice president of A&R at Atlantic Records, signing a number of artists and working on some of your favorite projects that have come out there over the past 4 or 5 years. Now he's transitioned over to the indie powerhouse Empire, where he'll be launching a new label and have a whole new role over there. So in chapter 4, we discuss that. I think something else that people may not know about you is that you've had the past 4 or 5 years, you've been an executive, right?
Yeah, for sure.
You were just at Atlantic Records for like 4 or 5 years, I believe.
4 years. Yeah, 4 years.
So what, tell me about your switch to, you know, that role as on the executive side of things.
I always, yo, this is what the craziest shit is. So like I do Big Sean, Bounce Back, and I have now, like, I'm starting to heat up on a string of records. Then I meet my business partner, Chris Sean, and we start going Chris Brown crazy or whatever. And I got all these Jeremiah records and I got all this stuff. So at that point, like, I reached out to Angela Yee and I sent her a DM, like, yo, I'm be in New York. I want to come on Breakfast Club. I just did this, and this. And she was like, all right, come up here. And I went up there and I was just talking shit. I wasn't even like, there was no truth to this and nothing. Like, I was just up there popping and I'm like, yo, like, I'm going to be one of the biggest executives in the game. Like, these labels, they started to look at me like that. I promise you. And I'm just saying it. And come to find out, I had a few more hit records. And then Ryan Press, who's like a mentor as well to me and a big brother, I was like, yo, telling him, like, man, I need to be executive. I need to be in this building. Da, 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 da. He ended up setting up a meeting with me with Craig Kalman. I went in there and told Craig, like, yo, like, I feel like I'm the next regime of the Irv Gotti's, the, you know what I'm saying, different subsidiaries, the Polo, the Dons, these different people. I'm like, yo, I'm him. I'm the next version of that. And y'all should believe that. Like, I got the stats to show it. He ended up liking me. Went and seen Julie. She ended up liking me. They all signed off on it, and it was a go. And I became a VP of A&R at Atlantic Records in 2016.
So how did you like working in the major label system?
I mean, to be honest with you, like, you know, listen, I'm gonna keep it real. This is why I work as hard as I do. When you got hits, you can do whatever you want to do, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so it wasn't like a thing for me. Like, when I would go into the office, what I put in my contract is that, yo, look, I don't want to go to the office. I want to go to the studio. Book me a studio 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, pay the engineer, and I just want to work. Any meetings that need to be held, come have them come to the studio. I'll go to the A&R meetings. I'll do all the other stuff when we all the whole staff gotta come. So it literally just got me a studio and I just started going crazy. And that opened the floodgate for everything. Like, I don't have to be booked by no label. Like, I literally was just, still to this day, I got my own studio, but like the studio I'm in right now, I still continued it. I just took it over from Atlantic paying for it. You know what I'm saying? When they were doing it.
So were they like just rolling their artists through there? Like, all right, yeah. just give this X, Y, and Z a hit. And
everybody. I mean, I did so many records with Atlantic Records, but some of the bigger hits together that we did, I'm pretty proud of is all those Meek Mill records, Whatever You Want with Chris Brown's High Dollar Sign, Meek Mill Dangerous. I just did the Pain Away record with Dirk on it or whatever. We did a whole bunch of records. All them records is platinum. I did A Boogie, Look Back At It, Star Tender, that whole album, we was going crazy. We did all those records. So, I mean, we've probably had like 5 number 1, 6 number 1s together.
And so you resigned from Atlantic and now you have looks like you have a big situation with Gazi over at Empire. Which is really cool. I love what Empire's doing, so I think that's a good fit. But what can you tell me about what you have going on there?
It's just the same thing. I just left Atlantic to go do what I do at Empire, and now I have more ownership and more control over a lot of things, and I have a true partnership. With Atlantic, it was dope, and this is what really happened. A lot of people don't know the details of everything because I've never really said nothing but I mean, it's you, so I feel like this family talking. I was an executive at Atlantic. I was getting approached by a lot of different people to do a lot of different things or whatever. Like, my first approach was, yo, Hitmaka, you should do a producer album. And I'm like, man, damn, I do got all these songs in my computer with all these different people on it. Maybe I should. What the fuck? So from there, I got approached a multi-million-dollar deal. And then now I'm like, I go back to Atlantic. And I'm like, yo, such and such wants to give me millions of dollars to do this deal. I want to take it. They like, no, you got to keep that here. You know, we're family, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, all right, bet. You know, all right, cool. So that's how A La Thought Box comes to fruition, and we end up going gold with that record or whatever, which is really dope. Shout out to everybody who was involved in that and the remix. And then from there, L.A. Reid comes into my life, and like, he's like, man, yo, like, I haven't felt this type of energy in a long time. Like, and you know, I have a high regard, and like, I look up to L.A. Reid a lot, you know what I'm saying? So he offered me my first label deal, like, and that opened the floodgate. Now everybody offered me the label deal. So from there, I go approach Atlantic, and I'm like, yo, Craig, you know, check this out. These people offer me a label deal, like, this big money, like, this not no little boy money. And, they're like, nah, you know, blah, 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 blah. Let's do this. Do it here. So they like, well, at least give us an opportunity to show you how much we care about you, Rob. They come back. They give me a deal. I do the deal with Atlantic. And then, but I think that they were just giving me deals to pacify me because other people were giving me deals and they wanted to keep me in that structure. And we kind of crossed paths and we got off track one day when they offered another artist that I felt like, because you know I'm on both sides. So now I'm the executive, I got a label deal, I'm a producer, I work with y'all, I got a song deal. So like I'm just seeing a bunch of different things. And from there, like I heard about a deal that they were attempting to do and that they were giving them more money than me. And I'm like, whoa, hold on. This boy don't got as many accolades. I done sold a bunch of millions for y'all. Like, nah, this ain't right. Like, y'all can't play with me like this. So from there, ultimately, I was just like, yo, I just want a studio. I just like, yo, this money y'all gave me. Like, if I go buy a studio, then what I'm going to do with the rest of this money? You know what I'm saying? Like, I, just invest in me like how L.A. Reid bought Tricky and Dream their studio, bought Tricky his studio in Atlanta, and they partners. Or like you did with Drama, a la Mean Streets in Atlanta. Like, let's do that some for L.A. And that never came to fruition. And then the pandemic happened. So then that stopped communication and got thinner and thinner and thinner. And then my job employment deal was ending and I was supposed to roll into my label deal. And then I just decided I didn't want to do that no more. And I'm like, yo, I want to go other different places. So they offered me like to be the head of this company, the head of that company. I was going to do my deal with QC and Capital. QCP is like a brother, a mentor to me or whatever. We were going to do that. But me and guys, we ended up meeting about something totally different. And we shared each other's stories. And I took a liking to it. And I felt like, man, like all these artists you got, like I'm going to run through this whole company like crazy. And that's what's happening right now. And it's about to start rolling out crazy as you're going to see for real.
Yeah. And it seems like you can have like more control over what you want to do, maybe with less red tape involved. Because I know just when you deal with the majors, it's a lot of bureaucracy and stuff that goes into that.
Yeah, most definitely. And man, I got my own label situation. I'm about to put out all my artist stuff. I'm about to put out my producer album stuff. Well, the first thing that's probably going to come out is Young Blue, the artist that guys he has, or whatever, the Sign of Empire, my bro. His first thing will come out is featuring some heavy hitters. We did it. That's going to be one of the songs of the summer, and this is going to go from there.